Hello, this is Dave Bazinet from the Solidworks training team. In this project, we'll showcase a design created in XDesign and brought to life through 3D printing. This project is inspired by a Tensegrity table, a structure that combines tension and compression to create a stable, lightweight design. In this project, we'll discuss design intent, part features, part design in the context of an assembly, saving to STL, and 3D printing. Let's dive in. When assembled, the Tensegrity table should support a small object without collapsing. Our table contains 5 parts, 2 base pieces, 2 arms, and fishing line or other alternative. The arms are a press fit into the base, and the fishing line ties the components together. I designed both pieces separately and used the arm to create the mounting cutout in the base. It's important to note that there are various ways to achieve the desired outcome. This is just one way to design the table. We encourage you to explore different design paths to make the table unique. Start by creating the main profile of the base and extrude it. Create the hook profile, then add a revolve. Add fillets to blend the hook into the main body. Pattern the hook and fillet to create the 3 remaining hooks. Add a cut to the center of the base and pattern it. These cuts add some aesthetics and reduce the material used when 3D printing. The last features are the cutout for the arm, which we'll talk about shortly. Like the base, start by sketching the main profile and extrude it. Sketch a circle, then extrude a cut through the arm to attach the fishing line. Finally, sketch the profile that connects the arm to the base and finish it with an extruded cut. With the parts created, it's time to assemble them. Start a new component, give it a name, and optionally bookmark it. Add the base by switching to the Assembly tab and selecting Insert. Search for the base, select it, and click OK. Then repeat for the arm. Mate these parts by adding a coincident mate to the bottom faces and a tangent mate to the outer face of both parts. Add an angle mate between the front planes of both parts and input a value. With the parts positioned correctly, create the base cutout to attach the arm. Edit the base by double-clicking it in the Design Manager. Click on the flat face of the arm and create a new sketch. Using Offset Sketch, select the same face and input a value. Make sure the offset points outward. This adds some clearance. Add 2 vertical lines. Then extrude cut up to the other flat face. The next step is to create STLs for 3D printing. Instead of saving to an STL directly, I'll use the Print 3D feature. For the base, I'll select the top face. This prints the part upside down and helps reduce support material. Next, I'll export it and repeat for the arm. In my printer software, I'll import the STL and arrange it on my build plate. Because my build area is large enough, I can print all 4 parts at once. To assemble the table, first insert the arms into each base. Depending on the offset value and printer tolerances, pliers may help with this step. Thread the fishing line through each armhole, wrap it around a few times, and secure with tape. Align the base halves as shown, and tie the fishing line around each hook. When finished, readjust the tension until the table is balanced and stable. A Tensegrity table is an excellent project for learning fundamental and advanced modeling concepts such as top-down design, patterning, revolves, and mating. It is also a fantastic way to explore STEM principles such as tension, compression, gravity, and design intent. Thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned to this channel for upcoming projects. If you found this content helpful, visit the site below for more content on designing with SolidWorks.